days here, the light changes in the opera room. All the sort of my vividness.
Well, we're part of vividness. I'm not sure how you are familiar with Oldstein's early life, but I wanted to start at the beginning by, you know, privileged background, private school, only child, college dropout, and then the adventures begin. You go to Vietnam to teach. Mm-hmm. You give that up after a certain time, join the Merchant Marine. Then you come back to America, and where does the creativity start? It starts there, doesn't it, with your first novel?
Well, you could say my father used to give me a quarter for every theme I'd write when I was a kid, you know, so that I'd get in the habit of writing. I didn't enjoy the writing, I enjoyed the money. So I was working for it. And I took the money because I wanted to buy comic books. Those are wonderful stories in them, classic comics especially. So that was really where it starts, kind of. But no, I never thought I'd be a writer until a few years go by and I started to write more because I wanted to keep a diary. I started a novel when I was 12, a French Revolution novel. Didn't finish, but anyway, I did write a novel, and that's very important in my development, because I went to, as you said, Vietnam. I came back that first time after the Merchant Marine and after the teaching experience. I did two semesters in Saigon and so on. And after that, I wrote about this protagonist in 19 years old. What else do you write about but yourself at 19? It's interesting how much of an ego trip it became, because. And it's important, I'm glad I went to the end of it. It really destroyed a lot of my civilized life in the sense that I went to the end of a 1,300-page manuscript with myself at the center of it. Now, I'm saying that as really as a Dostoevsky kind of revelation of psychology. Who am I? You keep asking. In every chapter, you change the style of every chapter. You go deeper and deeper and deeper. There is no end, it's an abyss. So you walk away, you don't know. And that's going to probably be the way it is for all of us at the end of the day, unless you're very confident and secure. But no, I never was. I ended up in the military, going back to Yale for a second time, dropping out a second time, zeros in all the courses, because I was writing the book, no interest in going to class. And I ended up I said, I want to forget this, I don't want to be all of this stuff anymore. I went back to my baptism name, which is William Oliver. I went back to Bill Stone and I joined the military. I wanted to be anonymous with short hair and just disappear and never make a claim again to being anything. And that's what happened.